Now, if today's gospel narrative can be seen as a statistical average, we're not very consistent in giving God thanks and glory. One guy out of 10 gave God thanks. 10% is all. I wonder if that's an average for we human beings for grace before meals or prayers before bed or, I don't know, thanksgivings at times when we have been given the chance to bring God into focus and intimately, but fail so to do. I think at times we get preoccupied with other things. Why the callousness? Why the taking for granted? Now, life is like a divided highway. They go in two different directions. Now, when we think about that in the spiritual realm, the highway of life that we are traveling, one takes us closer to God, the other leads us further away from Him. There is a saint, 6th century, I think. His name is Saint Maximus. And he said, better to belong to God than to ourselves. For it is on those who belong to God that divine gifts are bestowed. How true and how gloriously true that God gives us the ability to become one of His sheep. If we choose to belong to God, there will be a few things that we will do. And our example this day is of the story of the 10 lepers. First, when you need to be healed, ask God for help. Have mercy. That's what the lepers did. And that's what they received, the mercy from the hand of God. Number two, if you want to belong to God, then after the healing, thank Him in word and deed, and then give glory to God. Have you ever done something for someone and the person didn't say thank you? Likewise, how can we forget to give God glory and thanksgiving for the wonderfulness that He bestows on us? The leper who returned to Jesus is our model. Not the 9 who went their merry way, never to be heard from again. The 9 were just cleansed. They were not made whole. All they had was clear skin. That was it. And so the question becomes, I think, and we can ponder this, if I had the choice of simply possessing everything on my body working perfectly, or to have that and be made whole spiritually also, what would I choose? A vow to us this day is to live life thankfully, giving God glory until the day we die. And then, if we do, we will hear those words Jesus first spoke to the thankful ex-leper. He will say to us, with an added eternal meaning, rise, thy faith hath made thee whole.